welcome to the Gaia update for the new moon in Gemini that's happening on May 25th, 2017. I'm Adrienne Elise. Well, another really potent moon we have here, and new moons are always about new beginnings. In this case, it's a new beginning around communication and how we relate to others. And bringing in the information from this recent Mercury retrograde. On the 19th, Mercury, the ruler of Gemini, comes out of its shadow period, meaning that it's already gone direct, but until the 19th, it hadn't returned to its pre-retrograde position. That means that, and then also Venus is coming out of its shadow, or came out of its shadow on the 19th. So we're having a bunch of new energy and new chapters opening up. This is also supported by the north node, the nodal axis, the north node of the moon, moving into the sign of Leo. It's going to be there for the next year and a half, and Leo is about expressing and having fun and being who you really are in this world. So it's time to get on your path. And what's happened with this Venus retrograde this spring was it kind of went through all this territory. Venus is what we love, what we care about, what we really want in our life. So we've gone through all this territory to figure out what we really want. But now that these planets are out of shadow, it's time to actually enact these changes. And what's happening for people all around me and myself, it's what's coming up is what's not working. So there was a period of time, you know, where you could, whatever issues coming up for you, where you could kind of move along, be like, well, it's okay, it will resolve itself. And now it's like, no, something needs to happen. Something needs to change. Something needs to shift. And the universe is demanding that. And this is all part of how these personal planets, so our personal planets are those faster moving planets that are closer to the Earth. So we've got Venus and Mercury and Mars, and are the main personal planets. And so what's happening is these planets have been triggering this Pluto-Uranus square. And for this new moon, that is a definite potent thing going on, because Venus is hanging out right there with Uranus in Aries. And so Mercury passed over Uranus and Aries three times during its retrograde. And it's this massive shifting. Now the Pluto-Uranus square is about generational changes that need to happen in our evolution for us to move forward. Those planets just this spring have separated out of their exact square, but we're still feeling this energy because Jupiter's in a T-square with them, and the personal planets are coming through and going bam, bam, bam. And so it's getting personal, where it was like, oh, ooh, Pluto, you know, Uranus, oh, these big, this is about big energies, this is the collective, this is about what's happening to all of us. And now it's like, no, this breakdown is happening right here, right now. And what needs to be broken down in our lives is being shown to us really clearly right now. If you can take that opportunity to really use this time and say, oh, instead of being victimized by what's coming up in your life right now, be like, oh, okay, yes, it's been a long time and I haven't dealt with this. Keep continuing to push it under the rug. And now is my opportunity. Okay, the energy is ripe. This is the thing about astrology. If something's going on, these aspects, and you take that energy and you pay attention and you use it to your advantage, things can be much more harmonious in your path. And that's what this opportunity is right now. It's a huge energy around up and being done with the patterns, the things in our life, the structures of our life that are no longer serving the truth of who we really are. And with Venus hanging out right there on Aries, now Venus turned retrograde at 13 degrees Aries, and it's hanging out with Uranus later in Aries. And so what we have here is that Venus came up and got into the territory of Uranus and didn't quite make it there and went for a retrograde. And then Mercury went over in its retrograde three times, while Venus was cavorting with Chiron. Now Chiron is still activated really strong, the wounded healer, squaring up with Saturn. And so we are being called deep into our inner parts of ourselves to stand. We're the only people that can make the changes in our life, that can make our life better and more appropriate for who we really are. And that is the name of the game right now. It's time for humanity to stand up for the truth, for true abundance. And what that means is what this life, what really matters in this life. And so this Venus retrograde has been a huge activation for a lot of people to kind of tumble into their path, what they care about, what they really want. And now it's time finally to start enacting these changes, and we don't really have a choice because everything is coming up in our face that needs to be adjusted in order to move in these new directions. And so it might feel really squeezing like a snake and too tight of skin, and that is a very uncomfortable feeling. And the snake is at its most vulnerable as it's shedding its skin to predators. So there's an energy here of feeling very vulnerable, of feeling very sensitive, of feeling very emotional. And but we are being helped along by some other positive aspects that can really help us. So as much as Saturn square Chiron is really going into the wounds of the past and really not making sure that we get those lessons, as now Venus was hanging out so much with Chiron and now hanging out with Uranus. So it's like, okay, Uranus, the awakener, squaring up with Pluto, the destroyer, it's time to break some shit down that's no longer working. And that can be a scary, vulnerable feeling, because even what's not working in our life is what we've been used to, you know, and it's a support structure nonetheless, even if it's toxic. But right now, what's toxic is getting more and more toxic as an opportunity to show us what needs to be let go, shift, change. And like I said, great support to the universe to now just step out of it, step out of the drama, no back and forth, and whatever needs to happen in these changes in your life. And this could be just in your own psyche, in your relationship to yourself. So super, super potent time. So this Saturn is squaring Chiron, but Saturn is also trining, making a very harmonious triangle with Uranus. And that goes on throughout 2017. And it has this energy. It's the fire trine energy. And that's when all the fire signs have planets in them and they line up in a triangle. And so that's a lot of the energy of 2017. And it's like, let's lining up. You know, it's like we're here complaining about what's wrong, and we can't see what's right is waiting right behind the veil of illusion of what's wrong in our life. And so, and everyone around us is so, we're all so attached to the same right now, because we can feel this deep changes happening on energetic and spiritual and cosmic levels. And but now it's time for these cosmic changes that have been happening. The energy has changed dramatically on our planet since 2012. And yet this new moon in Gemini is speaking to the eclipses that happened in 2012. And so it was kind of a beginning. So 5 years ago, this is a cycle that's been happening here for the last 5 years. And we're finally getting to a point where we can stop and start a new chapter. So with Venus hanging out there with Uranus, that's also trining Saturn. So Saturn is our reality planet. Let's get to it. Let's face show me the money, you know, like face the music. Let's see what is really happening here. And so Saturn wants us to face the truth and get real with who we really are. And in Sagittarius, it's been lingering on the galactic center. It's finally starting to move off the galactic center, but this has been going on for the last 2 months. And so we're having this destiny feeling, like things are pulling us in directions, and often unexpected. Uranus is unexpected. It's the awakener. It's out of the blue. So this is such a crazy time, because it's like so much is trying to change, and yet it looks like it's, you're stuck in the same. And then there's this awakening energy, but when you start to move that awakening energy in your life, often you have to deal with the darkness, the shadow that comes up. So we're in this huge place of juxtapositions right now, and really hearkening back to what you have accomplished on an internal, psychic, cellular level of the last 5 years, and it's time to start showing that to the world. And that's going to be super exciting and super fun, and that's what we're moving into. But first we have to drudge through the drudge. And so once you let go, once you make that shift, once you surrender, then you can start getting on this path of beginning to share with the world what's happened within you in creative and fun and beautiful ways and empowered ways, with Leo being willing to shine. So it is time for us to shine, but we've got to get the tarnish off first. And so that's the process we're in right now. But with Saturn trining up with Venus and Uranus, so Venus is really speaking to us right now about the warrior goddess standing up for what you really want, what you really care about. She went through this huge journey, but she's still in Aries, and she's hanging out there with Uranus, the awakener, massive planet of change. And so now we're finally willing to face these changes that need to be made, and the universe is behind us. So don't be too scared. There's always a buildup of energy and uncomfortability, like that shedding of skin, right before the energy shifts and changes. These can be on micro levels throughout your day, or it can be in big energetic shifts that have gone on for years. But it's all culminating right now in this Gemini new moon. I'm calling it Clarion Call, because Mercury rules Gemini, Mercury and Venus just having this retrograde. Mercury's our messenger, our analytical mind, how we can figure out and make sense of what's going on. And so this is why it's a personal planet. It's our everyday reality. And so Mercury is about to inform us in this Gemini new moon about what's really going on in our everyday reality. How does this massive shift on the planet, what does that mean in my life? And now these are all really, this is all centered around relationships, because Uranus and Venus there, Venus represents relationships as well, are opposite of Jupiter in Libra. Now Jupiter expands whatever it comes into contact with, and so right now we're trying to expand our relationships and figure out what we really want at the same time. So Aries is about me, mine, what do I need, and Libra is about how do we make it work for everyone and work together and harmonize. And you know, and so there's a part of all of us that has been selfish, and a part of all of us that has been too much of an accommodator. And ironically, these massive generational shifts have to do with balancing these issues in our life. So this Gemini moon, new moon, is an opportunity to get some massive clarity, and it has been so confusing. But at the activation, we're going to tap into this clarion call. The clarion call is, you get on your path. The clarion call is, please give me the clarity, the light I need. It's coming in right now. I need to know and understand about how to move forward and what to let go of. And the clarion call is for your soul team, the other awakening team members, your soul brothers and sisters that are on a similar path. And we've all been living under this veil of separation. And most of these souls, these indigo souls, feeling like they're completely alone on this planet. There's just not even one person they can talk to. And this leads to some deep inner darkness. But right now, the light is coming in. And so if you can let the darkness be the path to the light and delve into it, let your emotions flow, face the truth, that can help a lot. And so this Gemini new moon is this clarion call of what these generational changes mean to you personally in your life. And we're going to look into that, get some more information, get activated, and reset the vibrational frequency. So I hope you can join me for the live activation. That's going to happen a couple days before the actual new moon on the 23rd, and there's information to sign up below. And I hope you can join me. If you can't make the live activation, go ahead and sign up. It gives you instant access to the replay, so whenever you're ready to go in and get that Gemini new moon activation, because this tapping into these energies is super, super potent, and it can help you move forward. And it's live even on the replay. So So you can get on the chat too and let me know how you're doing ahead of time when you sign up, and that can let me know how to address your needs more directly in the activation. Even if you're catching it on the replay, it's live even on the replay, because this energy that we're working with is encoded into the recording, and so you can still get that experience. So I hope that you'll join me for that. And in this new chapter, I have created a class to celebrate and activate and work with the issues of whether or not we have permission within ourselves to shine bright, to be who we are on this planet. And that's, I've developed the class called Leadership and Abundance Training. And this is about true abundance, the gifts that we have within, what really matters, what humanity is standing up for and saying, why am I living if I'm not really living? And it's like we're done with the game this patriarchal manifested 3D reality paradigm that has been keeping us trapped and unable to access our higher spiritual knowing, our connection to source. And it's like humans are fed up because it's starting to become beyond obvious that there's way more to this story and there's way more to this life than what we are allowed to experience. And so it's going to be a beautiful and amazing, exciting time as the leaders, the new leaders of the next generation, stand up and start living this truth, being a living demonstration of the abundance that we're here to thrive, to enjoy life. And that happens when we're on our path and expressing our true potential. All of us have worked for lifetimes to prepare our inner being for this experience. And the biggest toxin in this world is that potential being turned inward with diseases like depression, anxiety, and cancer, because we're not expressing what we came here to do. So it's absolutely the time. And so now is the time if you want to get on that. The live class starts on May 30th, and we're going to work together through an 8-pillar series looking at all the issues of all the major chakras and what might be interfering, past life, contractual arrangements, and learned conditioning that's in the way of letting our light shine and being that living example of true abundance. So I hope you'll consider joining me, and I hope I'll see you on the live activation. Until next time, I'm Adrienne Elise. Namaste.